the our sexual health is preserved through safe sex practices, minimizing partners, monogamy, the use of condoms.
Right.
And even circumcised men in Africa still need to use a condom.
I agree.
At least they made that choice, right? Those men in Africa.
But it's not an informed, yes, and that's coercion and misleading, honestly. Yeah. It's to take a country where economics are, where there's not great wealth, and pay someone to physically modify their body, I would say, is coercion and misleading.
Well, it's for health benefits. I mean, they're not modifying it. It's not like they're telling them to pierce their nose or pierce their ear. They're telling them, if you get circumcised, your skin is more exposed to environment or the air, so
correct.
When you have sexual intercourse, it's not like you're having from the inside out. It's almost like a person who's uncircumcised is almost like having a vagina.
Okay.
If I put it blunt.
Well, but a person who's
circumcised, his skin is like this. So the only place where it can have transmit the disease is through the urethra, which is exposed to, you know, almost internally. The skin is very permeable. So in general, if you look at scientifically, if you look like a logically, I mean, my skin here is more rougher than if my mouth or inside of my cavities. So when you circumcise somebody, you actually, I'm not saying 100% protection, but it adds, even if it adds 2%, especially people, there are people who doesn't practice safe sex, it's worth a while.
Are you aware that circumcised men transmit HIV to women at a significantly higher rate?
I need to see the actual paper or the study, which is, I'm a medical field, but so it's not.
It's there. It's there. I probably have it with me in my bag. We're actually doing a demonstration on this issue on the West Lawn of the Capitol.
Yeah.
So what happens when you have, you can't change form without changing function. So if you are aware of the function of the foreskin during intercourse with a woman, it's a gliding, movable shaft of skin. So what happens is, and it sounds like you understand the anatomy, it's a two-layered skin system. The external skin is cutaneous tissue.
Right.
The juncture, it's much like our face. This would be the external.
Right.
The lips would represent the mucocutaneous juncture,
right,
where the fine touch nerve receptors are found. The inner foreskin contains mucosal tissue. The glands of the penis is mucosal tissue in an intact man. During intercourse and upon erection, they essentially look the same, circumcised versus intact. Visually speaking.
Visually speaking.
The surface skin is different, yes.
Right.
During an inward motion of intercourse, the foreskin is
pulled
back. During the outward motion of intercourse, that foreskin has an enfolding action.
Right.
And what happens on the man, it occupies the space right immediately behind the coronal ridge.
Right.
Okay?
Okay.
The coronal ridge in a circumcised man draws out natural lubrication from a woman.
Okay.
Which causes, if sex it carries on for a long enough period, causes drying, chafing, abrasion,
that's more in a rape situation.
Not at all.
But if a woman
because
a woman is not ready, she would say she'll feel pain. She'll say, you know what, stop it. Use some lube or something. I mean blunt, so that's something.
Lube is not a natural thing.
I know it is.
Intercourse was never meant to be lubricated artificially.
Okay.
So here's my point.
We
lube
agree
is
to
required.
We need to do some more research. You need to do some paper a little. You need to read a little bit more about circumcision of sex.
Okay.
Yeah.
I've done so.
There's
I've
a
done
book,
so.
Sex and Nature Intended. It's a very good book with a lot of medical references.
I've read extensively. I'm the medical.
Look that one up. Sex as Nature Intended It.
If you look at the African studies, one of the aspects that was discovered, getting back to what I was saying, is that circumcised men are transmitting HIV to women at a higher rate because of the abrasion that's happening in the vaginal walls through pulling out her natural lubrication. The absence of a foreskin changes the dynamics of intercourse.
Right.
So when you have an HIV positive woman of childbearing age, you now have HIV possible transmission across the placenta to an infant.
Yes.
So HIV positive women are
it's a fascinating subject.
It's a
fascinating subject, but I think you should concentrate more on the rights of the baby rather than the medical, because in the medical you will lose actually.
I went to the medical because you brought it up as being cleaner for infection.
Okay.
Infection. Absolutely. It's a human
rights
issue.
Exactly. All about
it's
rights.
It's a medical ethics issue.
Right.
Nowhere in medicine do we resort to amputative surgery in absence of disease or deformity. genital tissue.
I completely agree.
Foreskin is normal genital tissue.
If you talk about ethics, if you talk about rights, I completely 100% agree with you. But when it comes to the medical, that's where I am a little not comfortable with.
And what do you do in the medical community?
I've done a lot of stuff. I am a microbiologist. I've done a lot of stuff. So.
Okay. Are you a physician? Do you?
I'm not a physician.
This site deals specifically with the issue of circumcision, yes. HIV transmission, and medical health. These are peer-reviewed, published medical journals. You will find all of that data here.
It's too late for me now because my mind is done.
Yes. But you work in the medical community, so your own continuing education and knowledge, please go there and read that.
Yes.
And see if you don't find that. You will find the study there that found that women were contracting HIV at a higher rate there.
I will.
That's where you will find all that.
Well, thank you for the intellectual conversation.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.